Okay, ladies, so we've had this awesome time together, you know, and I really feel like we need to make sure that we address whatever's in your heart. So does anybody have something that they'd like to talk about that hasn't been mentioned yet?
I have a question. So, okay, this is going to be kind of a tough topic, but I want to hear what y'all have to say about this. So because we're believing for a world where abortion is legally ended, where we are abolishing abortion in our lifetime, mm-hmm. what do you think is going to happen? Do you believe that we can actually stop it, or do you think that women are going to go and have illegal abortions? Are we going to see women going to the streets and some of the things that we saw before abortion was legal? And what would you say to a woman in that position? Because I think this is one of the major arguments that we're seeing from the other side, is people asking, well, won't women go and have abortions illegally?
Right.
That is a very important thing to address. Mm-hmm. And honestly, that's what we try to do, because the government's not God, right? Yeah. It's not all powerful. And thank God for that. But it's not going to be able to end abortion just by making it illegal, right? It's a hard thing to accept, but it is true.
Right.
And that's why we need to make sure that abortion not only becomes illegal, it becomes unthinkable. Mm-hmm. It becomes not the option you need to go with. That's what we do at Let Them Live. We help out women who want to keep their baby, but because of either financial circumstances or pressure from their friends, families, boyfriends, a lot of the times, they're being pressured into getting an abortion. And we help them, we help empower them, you know, our supporters, that's what they do. So we just need to keep doing that once it's illegal. Yeah. I'm all for laws outlawing abortion. I like heartbeat bills. I'm all for it. Mm-hmm. But I don't care what the state capitol does. I'm going to save babies right now.
Yeah, I think it's really important that we do both, because once Roe v. Wade is overturned, there's then going to be even state battles. So there's a while to making abortion completely illegal. Right. It's not going to be in one fell swoop. It's going to be a process. And as we're doing that, we need to have more of those mm-hmm. resources, but be ready and on the ground. And that's why we do have 1,200 groups across the nation, because those students are ready to respond at a moment's notice. Mm-hmm. They're ready to reach out to those women. But I think, too, there's a lot of fear for people, like, oh, my goodness, if Roe v. Wade is overturned, all the women who have an abortion is going to go to jail, or women are going to have all these back alley abortions, is the term they use, or be dying, because that is actually the lie that organizations like NARAL, Pro-Choice America, has spread. And the founder of that organization actually spread a number that tens of thousands of women were dying of abortion before it was made legal, and because they were going, you know, to mm-hmm. the back alley. But really, they were just going to the back door, literally, of doctors' offices, and the doctors were still performing the abortions. And Nathan Bernardison, who founded NARAL Pro-Choice America, later came out and said, actually, people started throwing that number around, and we knew it wasn't true, but it was a useful number, and so we kept using it. And really, the women dying were much, much lower number, maybe in the hundreds, which obviously we don't want any woman dying from abortion and ever feeling like that's the choice they have to make. So we do need to make it unthinkable and unnecessary. There's so much support and love and resources that they'd never even have to find themselves in that situation.
I love that, unnecessary.